with two broken chains, and what I'm going to try to do is make cannibalize one of them to make one good chain. I'll say that. Take some of the cross links, the good ones off of one, and repair the ones or replace the ones that are missing on the other. So let's find out which one has the most cross links, and that'll be the one we're going to add cross links to. I guess they're called cross chains. Get them all stretched out here. This one looks like, is this one pretty good shape? These are all good, all the way down. This might be my good chain right here. You know what? Nothing wrong with this chain, it's all good. Oh no, it does have a broken one right here. There is a broken. So it's only one? Cool. So what we're gonna do is take that one off. Bad of a job as I thought it was going to be. So it's only one cross chain here that's busted. This one, this little one. And right here. And usually what you can do is, they sell a link that you can put these together right here. And it's basically a chain link, and then you tighten it up with a finger tight. A little more than finger tight, and you can repair that. I don't have one, so what we're going to do is take it off. Place. See if I can remember how to do this. Yeah, this one. Spread it. Spread it with this one, and close it with that one. Just get it down here. You see how that is? Spread that dog, and take it out. What I do is I pin this bar down against my surface and then pull my weight in. Doesn't take much. And you can see that it spread. Spread the dog. Opened it up. Should be enough to now take it out of the link. See that? Like that. Spread it. Spread it with this one. Spread it, and when it comes time to close it, you'll use the other side of this tool and put it in like this, open it up wide enough, and squeeze it together again. See that? You probably gotta put it down on something to be easier. Yeah. See that it is now closed up. See that? It's now closed up. All right, so we're doing an instructional video. This tool here is pretty expensive. It was given to me by a party peep on the channel. And thank you so much, Paul. Thank you. Okay, where's that other? Track of it now. Right there. There's the other broken one. Spread it, put it over to the side. Well, what we have to do too is, before I get too crazy, I want to make sure I remember where I took it off in it. Usually you take a pen and mark it. Crazy here. That. It belongs right in between these two. And I'm going to leave it hooked there for the moment. And count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 links. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, the reason is there's a cam right here that's going to be representing two links, or one at least. So we're looking for the center. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to move it over to probably right here. I'm going to take one off of here, cross chain, and put it over here. This one has multiple broken ones, look. 1, 2, 3, 4 in a row that are broken. So we're just gonna cannibalize off of this one. Take one of the links, one of the cross chains off of this one and take it over there. And this is probably a chain I found on the ground that was somebody, some trucker threw it away. Sometimes these chains that are thrown away are good for this purpose. If you have the right tools, you can pick up a broken chain that some other trucker threw away. If you're an owner-operator, this thing here, though it's a couple hundred bucks, can save you from buying new chains. So just a little bit of work, you could probably pick up free chains every year. And this little $200 investment will be a godsend for your business. Spread it, and I can take it out. Now it's separate. Now I'll do the other end and move it over to the other chain. Easy money. That's the one I need. These are called dogs. Spread them out. Okay, we're gonna go probably right there. We gotta make sure there's no twist in this thing, because if you put a twist in it when you hook this up, more likely to break when it's driving down the road. So we wanna make sure everything's freewheeling on the twist, on the chain, no twist. Hook it in there. Take this one off that we pre-spread, and now we know where. Okay, I got my finger on the link I want it to go into. Make sure this has no spread, no twist on it. Good. Now crimp them down to the other end. This is the one I just did. Look how pro that is. Probably went a little bit too much. It'll be hard to open up again eventually, but there's a trick to that too. You can just cut them off. So this chain still has, let's count up how many it has left. One, good one right there. Two, three, four. Five, six. Six decent cross chains left. The rest of it, I mean, if you had enough cross chains, you could fix this chain and put it back to work. It's just missing all of them in the middle, so count up for the missing ones. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's missing four. Find another broken chain on the ground in my travels in the next year, I will pick it up, fix this one, or take what's left of this one and fix that one. Either way. Move this up in my chain rack. let's go.
Guys, let's go put it away.
Out here. So I'm going to put it back here so I know that which one is, I don't want to pull back off. So this will represent, these three chains are good plus that one over there I'm going to hang right here. Four good chains for the drives, and then I have two more for the trailer. I'll rinse.